For a species that has been dependent on communication since our very dawn, we're actually not that great at it. While deciphering current languages and scripts and communications between the world's many languages is easy in the modern age, there are still ancient communications and dead languages that we've never been able to decipher. An example here would be the early Linear A script of the Minoans on Crete, which was current about 1800 to 1450 BCE, yet remains untranslated to this day. We do not have a complete handle on human language, especially that of the past. There are entire languages that are extinct that left no records, and no one alive has ever heard them, nor will anyone ever hear them. Even today, languages and dialects are going extinct, and current ones continue to evolve. To add to that, we don't just have one way to create a language, we also have had great success with sign languages. As humans, we don't just talk, we can also sign. But all of these varying languages, current or extinct, translated or not, all share one key feature. They're all human languages. And we're not the only species on planet Earth that communicates with other members of our species. Much of the animal kingdom does as well, and we've yet to decipher much from them. A fine example here would be the dolphins. We know they're communicating, but that communication is so different from our own that we've made very little progress in figuring it out, other than finding patterns and correlations, but only to a degree. And to date, we don't even know if they have a language or not. What we do know is that dolphins, with great difficulty due to their marine physiology, can learn human communications to a degree, and even rudimentary language. A study in the 1960s by Margaret Lovett showed that a bottlenose dolphin named Peter was fairly convincingly taught to interact with humans using speech. Though again, a dolphin attempting to formulate human speech using its blowhole is structurally not ideal, to say the least. But headway was made, and Peter even learned to count. This is not even to get into the birds, dogs, cats, and myriad other animals that seem to understand us to a degree. But we, the great communicators of planet Earth, still cannot generally understand them. Though in fairness, I certainly hear about it and get the picture if the cat food bowl runs low. It may well be far worse of a situation with aliens, even intelligent ones. Because if we can't understand all of the communications being done by the animal kingdom on our planet, another planet could be next to impossible. Still, animal communications studies may shed light on just how to talk to an alien. This is a known problem within SETI and has been since the start. The work with Peter the Dolphin garnered the attention of Frank Drake in the 1960s at Green Bank Observatory, who dispatched a young scientist, Carl Sagan, to head to the Caribbean and see firsthand the work being done with this dolphin, in hopes that it might shed insight on alien communications should we ever pick up a radio signal. It's also worth noting that in 1961, a group of early SETI researchers gathered at Green Bank to discuss just how to use radio astronomy in SETI. It was no coincidence that this group called themselves the Order of the Dolphin. And the group included a very colorful scientist and friend of Timothy Leary, Dr. John Lilly, who had laid the groundwork of attempting to teach a dolphin human language, or more broadly, two very different intelligences learning to cross-communicate. He even envisioned someday the cetacean world being represented in the United Nations, for example. Incidentally, the product of that meeting of the Order of the Dolphin was the Drake Equation of SETI fame. While UN membership for whales and dolphins may have been a step too far, and setting aside the concept of uplifting animal intelligences technologically to be on level with ourselves, which opens a whole new avenue should we ever do it, in which case they might make up most of the UN, there is a coming option for deciphering animal communication that may outstrip anything else on this planet, and may be crucial in SETI should a signal ever be picked up. It's artificial intelligence. It's possible that with huge computing power, machine learning, and everything that goes with AI, we may gain a very powerful new tool not only in deciphering animal communications, but also alien radio signals SETI might pick up. But there is a spooky aspect to this. There's no question that if we ever pick up a signal, we will use AI to try to decipher it, which of course may not be successful in its own right. But since we've gone from the beginnings of radio to AI in just over a century, that probably means the two technologies are convergent everywhere. Once you get one, more often than not, you may rapidly reach the other. This would have an interesting effect. SETI astronomer Seth Shostak has said that if he ever does get a signal, he expects that whatever is sending it will be a machine. In other words, our AI talks to their AI. Let's just hope that they don't collude and give us incorrect information about what the aliens are saying. Or worse, we get a message that we use AI to decode and it translates to a warning. Do not develop artificial intelligence. Or, by all means, do develop it. That aside, the first arena we're likely to see AI translators will be in the animal kingdom. This is coming quickly. Projects such as the Earth Species Project are looking to use AI to better understand animal communication. It can be likened to a telescope. The bigger your telescope's aperture, the dimmer the celestial objects you can see. In this case, we only have the perceptions of humanity, which to a degree we can increase our aperture, as it were, through our scientific instruments. AI, in this case, is a further scientific instrument that can be used as a tool to increase our aperture further. One potentially really important result of better understanding of the animal kingdom is in figuring out how to protect and conserve the species we have. This has happened before. There was a time when whaling was an enormous industry, but as we learned more about whales and how endangered some of them were, and we discovered their still undeciphered whale song communications, we realized we better conserve these animals. As a result of conservation efforts brought about by increasing knowledge, many species of whales have rebounded in numbers, and we have also developed far better lubricants and fuels than whale oil. Another potentially weird one here is in memory and culture. Homo sapiens have been around speaking languages for several hundred thousand years, passing down information generation to generation. While it's difficult to know what information passed to us today is truly ancient, there is some evidence that certain folktales could be unbelievably old. An example here are the various myths surrounding the Pleiades star cluster. Numerous cultures ranging from Greece to Australia have variations of this tale. But the last contact between those peoples was tens of thousands of years ago or more. Interestingly, one feature of this tale common to most variations is the inclusion of a seventh sister in the group, which is not easily visible today with the naked eye, but was visible 100,000 years ago. It's impossible, of course, to determine for sure how old some of our folklore really is. But it's interesting. But here's the kicker. What if the animals are also passing down something, be it knowledge or language or something else? Well, Homo sapiens has been here for a couple hundred thousand years, but the whales and dolphins have been here for 34 million years. Echoes of the past may indeed be something we see in animal communications. On the other hand, there's a chance that none of this will work. The problem is that humans and the animals all have different cognitive abilities and modes, along with far different sensory experience and environment and many other differences. Not knowing what it's like to be a dolphin means that you have no foundation to build an understanding on. AI may never conquer that problem, or it may. It's also possible that the commonalities between us and the animals are numerous, and that gives us our basis. There is evidence for this. Interacting with one's pets show commonalities, but gorillas taught sign language have been able to give insights on what they feel. And emotionally, the gorillas share some common ground with us. And the gorillas have even shown some ability to empathize with humans. Though obviously that isn't always going to be the case. Just like it's not always the case for us. How to feed an AI looking to figure out animal communications is a matter of data collection. As many recordings of sounds, video of behavior, and so on as we can get will be crucial. Get a big enough data set and you have a chance at the AI picking out things and figuring out what's going on far more efficiently than a human can. Then you can likewise build a digital animal, say a whale, that can act as a translator and communicate directly with the whale. In other words, robot whales talking to real whales. I can only imagine what might come of that. But back to SETI and aliens and our AI talking to their AI. Figuring out animal communications is one thing, but deciphering a radio signal is going to be far worse. Here you have an extra step in the process. It would be more than simply listening to something and figuring out what it's saying. In between is the technology, and there's no guarantee of compatibility. An alien can't simply pick up our radio signals and understand them. They need a receiver capable of doing that, and translating it to a medium that can be understood. In our case, headphones or a speaker. They may not have those, indeed they may not even have hearing, so there are simply no guarantees. It's been suggested that an alien contact signal may show mathematical patterns that could be recognized, and thus would be a slam dunk for an artificial signal. Strangely, this may have happened. There are claims that the WOW signal had a message, and you'll see videos supposedly decoding it, and it's all a hoax. The signal was just raw narrowband radio energy near 1420 MHz with no sign of modulation, and the radio telescope was simply designed to detect radio energy and record its strength, hence the infamous 6EQUJ5, which is a Gaussian curve, if plotted out, as the telescope passed over the source. That's it, except there was something else. There were also several other concurrent signals stepping up from the main signal that discoverer Dr. Jerry Eamon circled. We don't know what these were, but there were two, possibly three blips. I wish we had more than 90 seconds of data on this signal because it's been pointed out that they resemble a radio representation, in other words artificial, of what's known as the Lyman series. With so few data points, it's really hard to establish, and it's not really a good statistical match, but it's interesting to kick around that there may have been a scientific message there. The main signal and the step-up signals, taken as two independent messages, would come out to this. This is what hydrogen, the most common element in the universe, does when it's cold, and this is what hydrogen does when it's hot. Hello? But I leave you with this, though. If we ever do decipher animal communications, and then we also pick up alien radio signals, might consulting the animals be the key to talking to the aliens? Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently eyeing the animal kingdom suspiciously. I think the really odd potential outcome of deciphering animal communication is the realization that they've been talking about us the whole time without us even knowing about it. I'm not sure I want to know what a crocodile thinks of humans. Bothersome, but sometimes delicious, primate newcomers. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.